Oh shit.
Hey yo, what the frick is going on?
Look.
Wait, you can't move your hands, right?
No.
Then I'm sorry.
What the fuck?
I'm a firing my laser!
Okay, I think this is a safe place. Okay, that means that I got time to talk about Godzilla Minus One! Now, before I start, I have recently heard that the suit actor for the Heisei Godzilla, Kenpachiro Satsuma, I apologize if I'm pronouncing his name wrong, and I just want to say thank you for him for creating so much of our childhood memories, and may he rest in peace. And yeah. Now, the thing is that let's talk about Godzilla Minus One in a more kind of let's talk about a movie. Let's kind of be in a more happier mood. And yeah, let's get into a more brighter mood. And which is Godzilla Minus One was a fantastic movie. It's amazing. And like, make a long story short, I will put timestamps so you guys can choose what part to watch. But to make a long story short, for the people who don't want to stay here for too long, go watch the movie. It is good. And in this video, there will be spoilers, so leave now. And also, well, it's mostly just gonna be me fanboying over Godzilla. So, if you can't handle cringe or stuff like that, leave. Like, please do. If you can't handle that. And I'm just making this video just to share my love for Godzilla. So, yeah. But anyways, when I watched Godzilla Minus One days ago, and I already made a short, literally like days before I watched it, or a day before I watched it, I think, or a day after. I forgot when I uploaded that video, but basically, the time spent before that video and this video, I kind of took my time to process it real quick. And what I realized is that, now hang on before you click off of the video. Godzilla Minus One is overhyped, but there's a but it deserves every single praise that it got from everybody. Now, what do I mean by that? I generally mean that a lot of reviews and a lot of people, especially on like YouTube Shorts, kind of like hype it up to a god tier descent, which it is, it deserves that. But like sometimes it's like we kind of have to like chill out a bit. Okay? It's a good movie. It's an amazingly good movie, but just chill out because for obvious reasons, not every single one of us is gonna move out of the movie theater and start screaming, "Godzilla Minus One is the best movie ever." We're like civilized normal people. We're probably gonna be like, "Yeah, this is an amazing movie," and like we talk about it. So, note again, I'm not trying to say Godzilla Minus One is bad or it's okay. I'm saying it's an amazing movie, but people kind of need to chill out a bit, and that's all I gotta say. But where do we start? Well, I guess we start in the beginning. Our main character, Shikishima, is a kamikaze pilot, and he was basically ordered to fly, crash, and kill himself on enemies, and yeah, kind of a touchy subject for some people, but he basically went to Odo Island, which is a reference, by the way, if anybody know that, and basically claimed or lies about his plane being malfunctioned, and the engineers were like, oh yeah, it's fine, it's understandable, nobody really, not everybody's wanting to kill themselves and die for a nation and stuff like that. And like, at the time, he kind of, it's like one of, it's a really complex subject to tackle upon, and I kind of like that about the main character, because like, when you put him in a situation like that, and then you have people who be like, don't worry man, I understand you, we all have the feeling where it's like we would tell that person to be like, yeah, okay, I understand, or you shut the fuck up. It's a really touchy subject, and not everybody likes to be pitied on. But during that time, we see some deep sea fishes kind of floating up, and I might be reading into this too much, but the way how the deep sea fishes look like, how they're floating and like bloated up and dead, could be a foreshadowing, or it could be like a prelude to the ending of the movie, where how water pressure, how they use water pressure to kill or attempt to kill Godzilla. Note, there is a little, when we get there, I'll kind of like explain the science, but basically at night, we like, everybody's just chilling out basically, and they heard noises, and the watchtower guy, right, was ordered to shine a light at the beach, and at that moment is where one of my favorite scenes from Godzilla Minus One starts. It's literally the moment when I knew that this movie was gonna be good, where right when the watchtower guy turned his light, we immediately see Godzilla, and he's unmutated, and like, he looks like a dinosaur, which is a reference to Godzillasaurus. You know what? English not working, but or Gojirasaurus, whatever versions you wanna talk about. But right when the light shows Godzilla, he said it's on sight and proceed to just like the poor guy, like he gone. He dead. Like, bruh. And I'm just sitting here being like, what did mans do? He like, what? And then the engineers proceeds to, and Shikishima to, hide in a little trench to hide from Godzilla. And one of the engineers, I believe his name, I can't remember on the top of my head, either Tsubasa or Tsukasa. I think it's Tsubasa. I don't remember on the top of my head right now, but told Shikishima to get onto the plane and use the gun to shoot Godzilla, but out of fear, Shikishima couldn't shoot him, which I can't blame him. That thing looks terrifying, and I don't want to deal with it either. And that resulted in Godzilla getting really close, and one of the engineers panicked, shot at him, and Godzilla proceeds to murder everybody. Like, the differences in this Godzilla compared to all the others. All the others is either a misunderstood monster or a allegory for nature and shit like that. This Godzilla, yes, it's a combination of like a misunderstood monster and an allegory for nature, but like, this motherfucker, he looked at everybody and said, yeah, you're all dead. Like, what? He said it was on sight. You guys are fucked. You guys can't do anything. But yeah, basically, after that whole Odo Island incident, Shikishima got home and found out that his family died, his home is wrecked, and I keep forgetting the character's name, but like, that's when we find the female or girl where she has a baby and stuff like that, and the baby's not hers apparently. So I was all like, okay, well, I kind of see what they're going with this. And again, I'm not gonna go too much into the plot, but generally, we just go through a whole, we just like see as their life evolves and like, and how like, kind of like this weird, not weird, but like how a bunch of group of broken people kind of come together and become some sort of like a family. And like, it's like it's one of the rare Godzilla movies, in my opinion, to actually make me care about the people, because I usually have like 3 or 4 responses whenever a human says anything, or whenever a Godzilla movie shows the humans. It's either fuck the humans, show me Godzilla, okay, sure, why do I need to do this, or okay, and that's pretty much it. But like, in this movie, they actually gives you time to develop a really good connection with the characters, with the human characters and stuff like that, and which the way how they do it is like very well done. And I'm hoping that if there is a Godzilla Minus 2 coming out, that they keep the role with the character development with the people, so then because like, we desperately need good writing nowadays, especially like what like movies are coming out recently. I'm not like Barbie and Oppenheimer were good, but like, if we see what like Hollywood has been pushing out lately, it's like, yeah, whatever. But anyways, that's besides the point. Really love the human characters, actually made me care. And when we head towards to the scene where like we finally see Godzilla after getting irradiated, his design is awesome, and it reminds me of the Heisei Godzilla so much. Like, it's as if you get the Heisei design and just like combined a little bit of like the Millennium designs, mush them together and make it into a CG model, and you get -1 Godzilla. And the way how they do certain things with him, like for example his atomic breath, when I first saw the trailer for -1 using his atomic breath, dude, it's like he's loading a gun and then just goes like, bruh. And in the movie, his atomic breath is like so powerful that like the initial shot, anything around that shot, anything around the beam, like it's not even need to be in direct like hit, it just has to be anywhere around it, gets destroyed. And once that thing hits something, it's a nuke, which kind of makes sense because, well, Godzilla got nuked, and yeah, which is a very nice thing, a nice touch. And I've heard that it's a reference to the GMK movie, Godzilla GMK movie. I haven't watched that, but I have heard of it, and I've seen a couple clips of it. And I've seen the explosion scene, and I can see it, and yeah, I think it makes sense. But as we go along the story and stuff like that, it's just like, they built so much character with Godzilla, and they built so much character with the human characters. We see Godzilla as this angry being that has been tormented by humanity, and the human characters, who are trying to rebuild their life. And it's kind of like, it's like kind of one of those things where you, like, you can't really blame one another. And the only thing that happens at the end is that we just try to live and survive. And the one thing that I really like about the trailer was the one line where I believe it's Shikishima, where he says that that monster will never forgive us. Really love that line. Weird how I didn't see it in the movie. Kind of weird, but I don't know. Maybe he said it in Japanese and I didn't, and they didn't translate that, but I don't know. I could be wrong. Anybody, please comment down below. And also, please correct me if I get any information wrong. So, yeah. And now before we head to the ending, let's kind of compare real quick to the last Godzilla movie. Well, last Japanese Godzilla movie. Where what I kind of weirdly find is that Shin Godzilla seems very political. Which makes sense. Like, of course Godzilla has always been political, if you know the history of it. But Shin Godzilla seems specifically, like, very political. And, like, and there's a touch of hatred, English. Shin Godzilla has a bit of, like, patriotic, like, themes in there. Especially, like, near the end. And where the final scene where, like, they played some very patriotic Japanese music. Again, if I'm wrong, please correct me. But, like, Godzilla Minus One seems patriotic by its nature because of the fact that these are, they're, like, solely focused on the Japanese citizens and, like, and the fact that, like, it's just them. Versus Godzilla, compared to Shin Godzilla, where they had some outside help, especially from America. Well, in Minus One, it's just the Japanese, and it's just like the shit that happens, where like their own government isn't willing to help them, so it's just a ragtag team of veterans and civilians just going up against Godzilla. And it's like, what? And the part where, like, they're making the plan to how to take down Godzilla makes sense. It's more unique, I would say. It's definitely more, because, like, they could have done the oxygen destroyer thing again. But I kind of glad that they didn't, because it makes the unique. But it does kind of look goofy at times, where before I continue any further, their plan was that they're gonna basically use two ships to basically tie around balloons around Godzilla and basically fill it with a gas. I forgot what type of gas, but it's denser than water, I believe, where it would basically sink him, hope that the water pressure kills him. And if that doesn't work, they would rise him up at, like, top speed and basically blow him up and, like, basically killing him with physics. Now, this is the part where the deep sea fish kind of, like, hit. Because when the moments when we see the deep sea fish, where, like, it show where it's a sign of Godzilla appearing, all the fish seems bloated and, like, and stuff like that. So, because, like, if you know anything about sea life and stuff like that, and that basically you can't really go down super fast underwater because that's gonna kill you, and you can't go up super fast underwater, especially, like, in huge depths, because the thing is that if you see, like, for example, whales, they dive pretty deep. And but the thing is, the way how they do it is that they go at an angle and then they slowly go down. They don't go. It's not like they look down and then they just go. Yoy! It's they go down slowly, because that kind of prevents them from like. It's basically like getting their body like ready for the water pressure and stuff like that, and it's not like immediate. So yeah. Basically, sea creatures are built different, and basically that's their whole plan. And especially like, if you've seen videos and pictures of deep sea fishes compared to them being deep in the ocean, and comparing them to up in the surface, they look vastly different. Well, not vastly, but like they look different. And especially like, I saw a YouTube short where a deep sea fish. Basically, its eyes are like blown out, its stomach gets inflated, and it's like poking out of its mouth. And that's basically the plan for Godzilla, where you basically sink him down, use water pressure, if that doesn't kill him, raise him back up. But due to his regenerative powers, he basically survived. And the one thing I notice is that right before he uses his atomic breath, if you look back a couple of scenes where he uses atomic breath, it seems like his atomic breath hurts him a bit. Like, he uses a lot of energy, and then, like, it hurts him a bit, but whatever. It's just an interesting detail that I saw. But basically, right before he kills everybody, basically, using his atomic breath, which also was one of the most terrifying scenes of Godzilla I've seen, because the man's literally his flesh was disintegrating while regenerating at the same time, and the pure white eyes are also terrifying. But anyways, right before Godzilla uses his atomic breath to kill everybody, Shikishima comes in with his plane and basically ejects and just blows up the plane into Godzilla's mouth, and presumably he dies. Presumably. And then when they head back to Japan, turns out that the female character, Noriko, that's her name, I don't know. Turns out she survived, but we see a black growth from her neck, and I'm praying to God it ain't super cancer. Please tell me it's something that is not crazy. Please tell me we're not gonna have zombie Godzillas. But anyways, after that, we do see minus one Godzilla. A little piece of him does regenerate back. Now, what concerns me is that that little piece regenerating back, is that the only piece that's gonna regenerate and make a new body for him? Or the rest of it gonna also regenerate and end up having multiple Godzillas? I don't know. But I'm just hoping that there's one Godzilla and one victim who is exposed to this weird Godzilla growth mutation virus thing. Because Japan in the movie has kind of been through enough. Now, no, basically to cut this video off right now then is go watch the movie, and if go watch with your friends, family. If your family doesn't want to watch it, cool. And if you don't have any friends, cool. Go watch it on your own, because it is worth it. And especially that I seen the trailer for Godzilla Minus One. Minus Color, where everything is in black and white, which is kind of a throwback to the 1954 Godzilla. But yeah, all in all, just to sum up everything, I'm a huge fanboy of Godzilla. Godzilla Minus One is a great movie, and you should all watch it. Now, comment down below, what's your favorite moment from Godzilla Minus One? And also, what's your favorite Godzilla movie? It could be anything. And also to sprinkle some anime in there and also some animated stuff. What's your favorite Godzilla show or animated show? And I know Godzilla Legacy of Monsters has just released. I haven't seen that yet. I don't know for sure about it. I don't really have any feelings about it yet, so I'll probably check it out later. But yeah, comment down below. What's your favorite moment from Godzilla Minus One? What's your favorite Godzilla movie/show? So yeah, anyways, have a good day. Peace.